and Justin are being slackers, but you know, it's always a good day when you got the bear.
Well, thank you.
With you. And it's that. Monday, so it's my typical ain't got shit going on. Let's do a stream Monday. So, hi.
It's a holiday here. Is it a holiday there?
Yeah.
Nice.
It is a holiday here. And, of course, yesterday was a holiday.
Well,
I didn't feel like cooking. That's why I got Chinese food.
Nothing wrong with that.
Chinese food's always open on Christian holidays, man.
Well, yeah. But I can't eat Chinese food anymore. Too much sugar and carbs in it.
There is a lot, but I wanted it.
That's fair. Whatever makes you happy there, Pilgrim.
I'm not worried about my diabetes killing me. I know what's going to kill me. It's going to be kidney disease, so I ain't worried about it.
So you're figuring, fuck it, just enjoy everything on your way out, right?
Exactly. So let's do the live phone call to Shadwell on stream.
My favorite part of the show.
Some bitch, he's the crazy bastard who gave me his phone number.
Fool.
I love his answering machine. It's in Espanol.
There he is. He's not going to answer because he's here.
What's up, guys?
Hey, Shad. What's up, man?
Yeah, I'm not answering the phone because...
No mamis. No mamis.
I do that when I get phone calls from people I don't know. I answer the phone and I was like, hola, ¿cómo estás? They say, I'm like, okay. And they normally hang up.
Yep.
And then I call them back to see who they were.
Yep. And
if I don't want to talk to them, I block them.
Yep.
I just don't answer the phone when it's an unrecognized number.
That's normally what I do.
Just let it go to my voicemail. If it's important, they'll leave a message. If it's bullshit, well, then I didn't have to waste my time on it.
I like to mess with people in real time.
And I never answer the landline. We have to have one. I guess it's a law or something.
You have to have a landline as a law?
I don't know.
You guys call Canada Canuckistan. What's up over there in California, man?
Well, I think it's either a school thing or a homeowner thing.
Democratic Republic of California.
Yeah, the Democratic Republic. The People's Republic of California. The People's Democratic Republic of California.
There's nothing Democratic nor Republic about it.
You got that right.
That's why it's a joke and it's funny.
RC, the PDRC, that's it. You live in the PDRC from now on, buddy.
I don't think it even counts as socialist.
Yeah.
No, it's full-on dictatorship.
Oh, fuck yeah.
For Citizen Newsom.
Yeah, New Scum is a fucking
individual. You haven't had a good governor since Reagan, for fuck's sake. You know,
like, and Reagan was not that
good. And Reagan wasn't great, but like he was the last effective governor they ever had in that fucking state.
They should have nominated that one kid from Different Strokes. What you talking about, Willis?
Gary Coleman?
Yeah,
it's so great.
That would have been hilarious.
All I'll remember to my dying day is I'm the governor, Pete Wilson, you know, the baddest governor to ever grab a mic and say, boom, give me a budget, watch me hack it. It's like, fuck. Disposable Heroes of Hypocrisy, when they redid California Uber Alice about fucking Pete Wilson, was brilliant.
This is why I was late, by the way, everyone.
Because you're playing space engineers.
Oh. Hmm. What brand of pizza is that you're eating?
Domino's.
What? Which one's what? Extravaganza? What is that one?
This is, they have a three topping special.
Yeah.
And it's got olives, other olives and sausage on this half, and ham, bacon, and pepperoni on the other.
I'm surprised you didn't get anchovies.
They don't carry them anymore.
They don't carry them.
Something to do with Portugal not selling their stock for the year or something like that.
I went and got me some Shin Ramen yesterday.
Nice.
I got some miso soup base.
Ooh.
So I'm having miso Shin Ramen.
Miso horny ramen? You're having some miso horny ramen?
So I'm the only one that had a traditional Easter meal, right? Ham and all the trimmings.
We had some sort of turkey roast with stuffing.
Well, I had Chinese food.
I didn't make it.
I had Chinese food, and then later on in the evening, I got a little package, so I had a bowl of ramen.
You had some Japanese.
Now, the day before, I made some beef ribs, and I had some leftover ribs, so I boiled those in my bone broth for my ramen. And I had those with my ramen with, you know, a soft-boiled egg.
I made deviled eggs, and somebody who shall remain nameless decided they'd cooked long enough, which infuriated me because I made like 40 eggs and about 18 of them, not even 18, 15 of them survived.
Pulled them out too soon, so they the yolk wasn't solidified. If you get them right away when they're like that, they're still good to eat. But.
Oh yeah, I love a soft boiled egg in my ramen. Mm-hmm. No, I get a soft boiled egg and I soak it in soy sauce and marin.
I've got a legendary recipe for deviled eggs that the boys just go ape shit over.
Well, deviled eggs are good. I don't care who you are. I always get dirty looks when I bring them to the church potluck. Though, what you bring? Deviled eggs.
And church was nice too.
Yeah.
I didn't leave the house yet. Yes, I did. I went and got Chinese food.
Just despite the power outage we had here for about 12 hours, it sucked ass.
No. The People's Democratic Republic.
It's the first one we've had, and of course, I was the only one ready for it. You know remotely prepared.
They finally brought the rotating power outages back.
We had a power station catch on fire.
Really?
That's what they tell you.
Is that the garlic butter dipping sauce, Justin?
This is
cheddar jalapeno.
I love that one, but they don't have it on the pre-select. You have to go into the menu, and I was being quick.
Yeah.
This is just the normal garlic.
They have they're having a sale in Canada for, I don't know if they're having it in Ontario, but in Quebec, all pizzas for this week are 50% off.
Ooh,
that's cool.
We had that 2 months ago, I think.
Yeah, we get it every few months, but they're having it now, which is really kind of cool.
Okay,
I may actually treat myself to an Easter pizza for supper.
I'm gonna make pizza for dinner tonight.
I like garlic butter, the garlic butter dipping sauce. Mobius, how you doing, buddy?
They don't have garlic butter dipping sauce.
People shit on Little Caesars.
No, most places don't have the garlic butter, but if you go to Papa John's, they give it to you for free with every pizza.
Yeah,
there's a Papa John's, but I have to use Uber to order from them, and so it's really expensive.
Yeah.
People always talk about Little Caesars pizza. I like Little Caesars because, you know, crazy bread kicks ass. And they've got the garlic butter. So you go in, you get the hot and ready pepperoni pizza for like $7.59. You get your garlic butter sauce. And now they've got crazy bread crust on their pizza if you want. But I like the pretzel crust pizza. Mm. With cheese sauce instead of tomato sauce.
I remember the hot and ready before the coup was like $5-6 or something like that. Now it's almost 12.
It's like $7 here.
Yeah.
It's like 10 here. But
well, yeah. Everything's more expensive in the Republic of California.
Yeah, people's fucking thing.
The People's Republic.
The People's Democratic Republic.
So we have Little Caesars here. There's only one in the city that's out on the West Island, so I have to go pick it up if I want it. But the price is amazing. like what you pay $25 for at Domino's, you'll pay like $17 for there, which is insane. Like that, just, that price difference is so good. And it's actually not bad pizza, but I did learn one thing. You got to order extra cheese because they do not put enough cheese on their base pizza.
That's weird.
On the cheese, and they use a mix of Munster and mozzarella on their cheese, in their cheese.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I used to manage those Caesars when I was younger.
That's weird. Jackie says there's too much cheese on a Little Caesars.
And if maybe you get in the States.
Maybe. And when you get the Hawaiian pizza, which I know everybody here hates, it's actually like, wow, they need a lot of cheese on it.
What are you talking about? Hate? I love Hawaiian pizza.
Oh, really? Hawaiian pizza is not bad at all.
Especially if you get bacon with it. Bacon, ham, and pineapple is a damn good
pizza. I get bacon, ham, pineapple, and jalapeno. So you get
you can do that.
And the spicy and the smoky.
You know what? There's two ingredients you can add to the Hawaiian that just freaking kick it up a notch. That's red peppers and onions.
Yeah, you can go for that too.
Oh,
I don't get the onions because the pineapple has enough sweetness. Mm-hmm. I get pineapple, ham, bacon, and jalapeno.
Yeah, I can't do green peppers, so red peppers, they okay with me.
I think they only have the roasted red peppers at some places here. We don't have like red or green. It's just green.
Oh, okay.
Or some places have roasted.
Wow, trip out. Everywhere I go, I get shit for liking Hawaiian pizza. And everybody here is like, yep, good. All good. All right.
Well, I think a lot of tribe, a lot of people talk shit about Hawaiian pizza, especially online, is because they want to be like, ooh. But everybody knows that they like pineapple on pizza. Everybody likes pineapple on pizza. They just are freaking ashamed to admit it. And you know, I ain't ashamed of shit.
I've seen that.
Pineapple goes great with anchovies.
I've never had an anchovy, so I don't know.
I like anchovies and black olives.
That's almost as bad as not thinking of Rome, bro.
Anchovies, black olives, feta cheese. Now, in Florida, there's this little mom and pop's pizza place, and I mean, it was, oh, man, it is good. And my favorite pie they had there was the sausage and gorgonzola. Gorgonzola and sausage on a pizza.
Mm-hmm.
And they put the fresh garlic. Oh, my God, it was so good.
So welcome to the pizza channel.
Oh, you know, it's Hungar's Chaotic Neutral live stream. You don't know what we're going to talk about, but we're going to talk about something.
Yeah, absolutely. It's good to have you back, Hungar. How was your vacation?
Exile. How was your exile?
My hiatus was pretty good.
The Isle of Malta.
I didn't go on anybody's shows. I just slacked around.
Yeah, same here. I couldn't do my show Saturday. I didn't do anything Friday. Had a game, and it was nice. I got a lot of reading done during the blackout.
Look at this sexy some bitch down here at the bottom. Didn't even know he was here.
Who is that? I can't tell.
That's Jane.
That's my goofy brother.
Hey, what's happening? I didn't get a chance to watch your videos on your favorite 10 monsters. I'm not going to do one of those because I don't want people like suddenly using the monsters I use, and I want them to be a surprise.
Okay.
All monsters should be your favorite monster.
Yeah,
no, that's wrong.
No, some monsters are just kind of lame.
Well, yeah. How do you feel about pineapple on pizza?
With ham, it's pretty good.
Okay.
Try it with bacon sometime. It'll blow your mind.
Well, hold on, though, Bear. You're Canadian. When you say bacon, what do you mean?
Okay, so I'm going to settle the score on the Canadian bacon thing. That's a you thing, not an us thing. We call breakfast ham. You guys decided to call it Canadian bacon.
It's called Canadian bacon at the grocery store.
Yeah, but that's because Toronto desperately wants to be fucking American, so they take on any bullshit America does and they make it Toronto.
No, it was literally marketed as Canadian bacon originally.
By who? Maple Leaf?
The guy that invented it. There's a whole
Except no one in Canada calls it Major League Make fucking Canadian bacon, except maybe people in Toronto, man. Come on. I live coast to coast in the city. I've never heard anybody call it fucking Canadian bacon in Canada.
The guy that invented it?
Good for them. They're fucking idiots. It's shoulder ham. It's a shoulder cut. Fuck.
Yeah. Like it was...
And it's breakfast ham. Go find it in the supermarket. Breakfast ham.
See, I agree with Bear in principle because I have this kind of ham I buy. It's a sliced Kentucky ham. And it's like the same thing. But they don't call it bacon. They don't call it
back bacon's a different beast completely. Now, back bacon is a fucking treat.
Y'all bacon is where it's at.
Well, yeah, our grandma made bacon out of the pig.
But anyway, that aside, throw some regular old fucking bacon on a Hawaiian pizza and you'll fucking do your taste buds a favor.
Not this crap. Not this crap here.
Yeah, not that ball bacon. I fucking hate that shit.
See, here's the thing is like, I don't like bacon on pizza at all. Ever.
Well, we can never be friends. I'm sorry.
Like I'll do ham and pineapple occasionally. I'm not like a weirdo like that.
But. I want these bacon bits, not the crumbles. The crumbles come in a shaker.
Right.
The bits, the ham slice, and the full strip of bacon with pineapple and some cheddar cheese on top to hold it all down.
See, my daughter kind of got me addicted to a kind of pizza. It's pepperoni, banana peppers, and black olives.
That's a good pie right there.
That sounds weird.
No, that's
good. It sounds weird until you eat it. And you're like, oh my God, this is so good.
How are you doing, Nakata? Another good pizza is, of course, the PMS.
Yeah, pepperoni, mushroom, and sausage, right?
Yeah.
It's hard to fail with that. If it's real bacon, it's fine. If it's that shit out of a jar, no thanks. Yeah, for me, man, I love bacon. I'm a bacon eater, just like every red-blooded American is.
Yeah, I actually gave up bacon for Lent, so that was rough.
Oh, my goodness.
I know. It was rough.
I gave up sex for Lent in 2018. I should really get over that.
Yeah,
that was great, Bear.
Life is good. I'm glad to hear Dakota's doing good. I hope he finally retired. I know he was close last time we were, like a couple years ago.
Talking. I want everybody to be doing good.
Of course,
except Nancy Pelosi and Justin Trudeau.
Hold on just a sec, guys.
You're in trouble now. You spoke badly of Nancy on a fucking Californian's audio frequency. You're in trouble, Hungar.
He's not coming back from this trip to the bathroom. No, he's getting shot twice in the back of the head.
Yeah. Oh, he's coming back. He's just going to look slightly different. Like he's like a shadow.
In a perfect world, Justin Trudeau would go through a Mr. Scrooge experience. Where, like, he'd be visited by three ghosts in the middle of the night, and he'd wake up the next day and be like, I'm a fuckhead, and I need to change everything I've been doing. That would be my wish. Not any harm, but I'm not, for one, Mobius, I just woke up, and I'm just, this is my computer's actual speaker. I usually have my nano, you know, I've got one of those nano speakers or microphones. Thank you, Justin. Thank you very much. My mind is.
Yeah, it's okay.
So.
It hasn't been there since 82.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, but if Trudeau had like a Dickens experience.
Yes, like, something like that. That's what I would.
It would be like Castro, then. Like Mao,
but that would be okay if they showed up to be like, look, what you're doing is wrong. We were wrong. You were wrong.
And then he'd come out and like the starvation camps would start up.
Well, anyway. No, I've got a hard decision to make. Do I go to my favorite Cuban/Mexican restaurant or do I go to a new Greek restaurant that opened up?
I would. Oh, I love that Cuban Mexican restaurant.
See, yeah. Look, that doesn't quite look like Shadow anymore, right? No, it's like a guy.
The hair. Like, look at his beard. Look at his beard.
Wrong. It's all wrong.
Like, it's like a V instead of the little twist.
Yeah.
What did we do with the real Shadow?
This is the replacement. This is the Slobodan.
Yeah.
This is the People's Democrat Republic of California's replacement of Shadwell.
Shit. There's no replacement for me.
This is the respectable comrade Shadwell, the commissar of.
You know, it'd be funny if everyone in this chat was actually a secret operative for some nation, but wasn't telling anybody. Like Shadwell was working for, you know, whoever, and Justin was part of some Canadian intelligence group. And
Shadwell would be working for the People's Democratic Republic of California.
You might be working for a different Canadian group that doesn't know that Justin is working for a Canadian group.
We don't have that kind of funding.
You're working for CSIS, and I'm working for the people I work for.
Justin is working for Mossad. Because that would just be fucking
that hilarious. Would be the best. That would be Justice really is a Mossad agent.
That would be hilarious.
And I am a Russian agent.
And I'm just Hungar, oblivious.
What was it called? The Family or whatever, where they're all like Russian plants in deep cover?
The Americans.
Yeah. And Hungar is like the NSA, but he's actually a double agent for the People's Republic of China.
Why do I got to be the double agent?
You're just wearing red. Like, not only that, but he's so friendly. He looks like he could make a lot of friends.
But Justin would definitely be working for Mossad.
I could see it. I mean, if you look at him, he does got that kind of dark, swarthy, kind of Middle Eastern look to him.
The Mossad stole Justin's bike, and he's still bitter about it.
The Mossad stole Justin as a child and trained him to be the ultimate agent.
I'm a golem?
No, you are the ultimate Mossad agent. You go into, like, chats and talk a bunch of shit.
Haven't you heard my theory?
Recording at all.
Haven't you heard my theory about the story of the golem?
The golem is a horrible thing that we don't talk about.
We don't want to hear that story.
The clay is Goyim.
We don't want to hear that story.
Yes, we don't talk about golems. Next, you're going to want to talk about freaking Devic boxes and shit. We don't talk about them. You know what I'm talking about.
I mean, every
massage agent would.
Shadwell just works for the People's Democratic Republic of California.
Yeah, fuck them.
But isn't that the mantra of the People's
Republic? No. Shadwell's extra special because he's actually a deep sleeper agent for the Democratic People's Republic of Northern Korea.
No.
He's just of the People's Democratic Republic of California.
Yeah.
Like... So he gets his orders from Kim Jong-il or Kim Jong-un.
Well, doesn't everybody in California?
Yeah, right.
Raven. But it's not like the current one. It's just a recording loop from like a 1950s.
Cal is giving away all of his game stuff. Has he decided to go outside and touch grass?
Are you okay,
you've got to be kidding me, Cal.
See, the thing is, I think I can't say anything because Hungar
isn't worth it, bro.
How many times have I thought about giving away all of my game stuff?
Yeah, and then you just buy more and you feel better about it. Cal, do you need
about once a year? Oh, it's April Fool's Day, duh.
I was going to say, otherwise, you know, I'll make you a good offer, you know.
about once a year.
You would, Shadwell. You would take advantage of somebody's, you know,
pain and misery. Fuck yeah. Half my collection is covered in tears. Are you kidding? And they're not mine.
I'm not even joking about once a year.
No, they're from the people.
I think about giving it away.
The people from Republic of California, of course.
Well, you know, the way Shadow grows his collection is he finds a dissident, just a person he likes the collection of.
Hey.
He has them dragged off to re-education and possesses all their
brothers. They said bad things about Nancy Pelosi. They must go to the re-education center, and we must organize ourselves to study all their books that they have to see if there's any... Dungeons and Dragons, that sounds very subversive. I should look into that deeply. I will take these books to my office.
That voice is perfect. No. Then don't lump me in with that fucker Soros. Yeah, they don't, no.
Fucking moron. No.
I got to ask you, how long was the course at Berkeley to get you to break that accent? Because I know the one Bear was using was your original accent.
You're not even close.
My name is Shadow. I got a son. We got a channel. It's really good. You should check it out. Unless you're some sort of pinko commie bastard, then we're going to send you to a re-education center. It'll be great. Perfect for you. And that's why he talks shit about California, because he wants to lure you in like a fucking FBI guy.
Like Justin, he talks all that shit because he's trying to lure you in and get you to agree with him.
He's trying to
and expose. And that's all on recording.
Exactly.
And then boom.
Found me out. Busted. What can I say?
I know this personally, and Hungar knows this. There were some dudes at the end of the town I live in. I mean, literally like 5 miles away. And they got arrested for trying to build a bomb. Because apparently they were going to blow some shit up or something. And they were all a bunch of those, you know, waving those red flag kind of guys. The red flags with the white circle in the middle and the little, Hindu symbol.
Sunwheel? A little Nordic sunwheel? They all
got let off because the FBI agent had taught them all how to make the bomb. All the parts. And it turned out they were your typical, retards. Were your typical tryhards. They had no idea what they were doing. And the FBI agent was the one who put them up to everything. Basically leading them.
I wouldn't be surprised if the FBI agent was the one that introduced the iconography into the group in the first place.
They were always that way from high school.
The feds in your country is really bad for doing this for decades. They'll find like edgy kids in high school and raise them up into groups just to manufacture this shit.
Yeah, it's like they say.
If life is going good and nobody's committing crimes, who needs an FBI? We got to make money over here. Come on.
I love that. Yeah, you sound like a good fella.
That's the thing. Literally, the difference between the feds and the organized criminals is a fucking badge, and that's it.
Yeah.
I saw this meme yesterday. Dad, I've decided I want to get into a life of crime. And the guy's like, he's like, awesome, son. Will it be banking or insurance you'd like to go into?
You know? When people say, I'm going to go into crime, it's like, public or private sector?
Yeah, you go in private enterprise or public service? Which one are you going to do?
It's like, one of them's got insurance and the other one's...
It provides insurance.
It's like when you see these people like Mark Cuban, and he's all like, I'm a multi-billionaire from stock trading. And it's like, what?
The fuck you say?
The FBI is almost like, that's a real nice freedom you have there. It would be a shame if something happened to it. You know, like that's what they've gotten to. It's that bad. Fuck.
Oh, I love the guys. He's just walking around with his camera filming random shit legally. And the cops walking up, well, you're not allowed to do that here. It's like, it's protected right. Well, I don't care about that.
Well, that's called clear water.
Yeah.
I'm not even joking. go to Clearwater, Florida, and start recording anything within three blocks of the Scientology building.
Yeah, they fuck you up, buddy.
And they come out of there like freaking ants out of a nest.
Yeah.
They start recording you, accusing you of all kinds of crimes. And all of the cops that work for Clearwater have off-duty jobs working for the Temple of Scientology. And yeah, they get paid like twice as much as they do working for the police department. So
I don't know what you're talking about. Scientologists are lovely people. They're the nicest people you could ever meet, and they have only the best intentions in mind. And I can't listen to any of these crazy things. I'm sorry, sir.
Yeah, they're something.
They're amazing people, just like the Clintons. They're good people with wholesome hearts trying to make the world a better place. And
yeah, yeah, okay.
That's all I have to say on that. Mobius.
Yeah, have a wonderful rest of your day, Mobius.
Take care, buddy. We're not talking about pizza anymore, so he's got to leave.
I like the pizza conversation, especially like there's this place in Washington that apparently has really, really good pizza. It's something like Asteroid Pizza or Haley's Pizza or Comet Pizza, Meteor Pizza, something like that. Apparently their pizza is really good. The Clintons order it all the time.
Yeah. That was
debunked. Bear, right here, Bear, right here.
That was debunked by a guy who got arrested for
ordering his pizza.
Ordering a lot of their pizza.
Yeah, it's interesting how the guy that was triggered by the QAnon conversations and shot up Com Pizza conveniently shot the server that had all the digital imaging on it and destroyed it. I mean, that's just, I mean, like, talk about a bad day. You're going out to prove some nefarious shit and you accidentally destroy the evidence that you were going to get. I mean, that's, man, that guy's cards were just coming up bad that day, you know?
Yeah, I had a rough day.
I'm thinking Greek food. They might have some good calamari or something.
Get yourself a lamb shank, man. I love a lamb shank.
Get a lamb's head and eat the thing straight.
Yeah, right. Eyes and all.
Oh, yeah. Don't fuck it.
It won't taste as good afterward.
No, I'll probably.
The royal family from Saudi Arabia came out to the island and killed a goat and, like, put the head on.
That was when our parents ran the catering service, and one of the princesses or some shit from Saudi Arabia rented, like, the whole island and brought a goat out. And we're like, we want you to cook this. And my mom was like, I can't kill that. And they're like, don't worry, we'll take care of all that. All you got to do is cook it. And they tuck it around the building and did their thing and come back with a skinned goat.
Except the head they used as a centerpiece. And then
they left the head as the centerpiece of the dish.
And the prince popped the eyes out and ate the eyes.
Yeah, and the prince was crazy because he was like 7 years old, but dressed in full military gear with a sidearm. And it was a real sidearm.
This is why we need to get off oil, just to end Saudi Arabia's bullshit. You just bankrupt them overnight.
He
did
get in trouble, though, because he ran his little sister over with a golf cart. And they tuck him into the room because they weren't allowed to yell at him in front of people. But they tuck him in the private room and they yelled at him. And my mom walked in and she's like, oh, I'm so sorry. And they're like, no, it's okay. You can come in. Because they loved my mom for some reason. Like all of the Saudis that visited loved her. But some people have actually asked her if she was Arabic. I don't know why. Her skin is as white as white can be, but she's got that kind of almost kinky long black hair. Like wavy, I guess. And she's been asked if she was Egyptian or Syrian or you know, Turkic or whatever. And she's like, no, honey, I'm from Kentucky. And they're like, oh, okay. You know, but yeah. And what Bear says is 100% true. Because, and it's so weird too, because the women would come to the island in their abayas. And then they'd take their abayas off and they'd be wearing like these slinky, sexy dresses and high heel shoes. But it was okay because no one could see them there but them. And also, the stories I heard is the Saudi princesses, the female versions, they would go out to like Disney and nightclubs and shit and get involved in all kinds of crazy shit. But it was okay because they were over here. But mm-hmm. then when they went home, they had to put the abayas back on and everything. So it's a thing, man.
It was crazy.
Yeah, we worked with them. It's basically lamb in a butter sauce with a shit ton of rice.
That sounds good.
Yeah, that was pretty much what we made. So, you know, it was like, and you serve it on a big old platter on a big circle table that's like a foot off the ground. And everybody just kind of sits down on you know, at ground level and just eats with their hands, you know. There's no, like, serving dishes. There's maybe a knife. And, you know, and that's just how it's done. So, and a lot of flatbread, too.
Yeah.
Mom can make flatbread, so.
The good place I liked was Jerk Chicken. Closed, what, a year ago? And I haven't been able to find a good place that delivers lamb.
Do you guys make a lot of lamb up there? Because lamb is kind of a rarity in America for some reason.
I've never even had it. No, I've had it once.
I don't like lamb. I don't like mutton.
Yeah, you don't care for it?
Not a fan of the flavor.
I like the occasional spiced lamb shank, but not regularly, but yeah.
See, Cal says his wife eats in that traditional manner with her hand.
Where's his wife from?
He never said. I know she's at some non white ethnicity, but that
I think she's from Africa.
Yeah, if she's from Ethiopia, they eat like that.
Yeah, and that place also closed. Blue Nala. I missed that restaurant. It was the Ethiopian restaurant.
Yeah, it's basically various types of mushy stuff on a table with some bread.
Yeah.
And generally pretty spicy.
Yeah.
They like their food a little hot. But, Zambia. Okay, there you go. So,
yeah, I've had lamb and I've had mutton. As I said, I don't like either. Like I said, both, sir. I don't like the flavor.
The second or third most beautiful woman I ever saw in my life was like from Nigeria or something.
Dude, there's some beautiful Nigerians.
Like I worked with her in we've got the Gaylord Hotels down here. And I worked at the Gaylord Hotel and I don't know what she did, but she was definitely top five when it comes to just natural 100% just beautiful. Like everything about her was beautiful.
The Gaylord.
It's yeah, man.
Yeah, it's a chain of hotels, I know.
Oh yeah. I was like, yeah, the name is a thing, but this place is like a mile across. I mean, you know, it's huge.
It's where your Republican convention happens in Vegas every year, the Gaylord Hotel.
Yeah, and,
unless they moved it. It used to be the Gaylord Hotel anyway.
I don't know. And the other top five most beautiful woman I ever saw also worked there, but she was from Argentina.
Yeah, but she was a bit of a...
But she was a hooker.
Argentinian?
No, they caught her having sex with some dude in a closet. And, you know, they're like... It's really sad because she was just absolutely like at least a 9 or a 10. She was amazing. But she was married too, so I wasn't, you know, and I was dating, so it's not like I was going to try and do anything. But, and then there was a Peruvian girl who asked me to marry her, and I had to be like, I've already got a girlfriend. She's like, that's okay. I was like,
hey, Shadow, what vine do you have growing up there?
I have no idea.
It's a green thing that came out of the ground and started going places.
Yeah. You're also breaking my new rule.
The doorway.
Yeah. It's just not safe, man. I'll tell you later.
You can tell him now. What if we're sitting here looking at you, Shadwell, and your wife don't know that your recording comes walking across that doorway naked?
No, she ain't home, so.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, TCG?
I mean, a lot of stuff can happen when you got a door behind you.
Yeah. You already make enough of that kind of content, bro. You don't need to make more.
I'm paranoid anyway. When I go into a restaurant, I always sit facing the door.
Yep. Oh, yeah,
everywhere I go in public, back to a wall, face to the entrance.
The door is that way.
Yeah. Yeah, I used to get in a lot of trouble with Jackie's school events that she'd let us, you know, come to. I'd literally stand at the doorway like, you can't be there. I'm like, why not? Oh, you just can't. Well, I'm leaving then. I'll wait for them outside. And they're like, what the? It's like, you got 1,000 people. If something shit goes down, I'm going to be the first out the freaking door.
Oh, man. I just looked up where he's from. Zambia. That's one of the countries that are part of the stomping grounds of Gustav.
The giant crocodile that used to eat a lot of people.
He's still maybe out there. Some people thought they got him, but then they're like, they've been sightings of him.
When I go out, I like to sit in a corner with my back to the wall where I can see the door.
He's easy to recognize because he's got scars along his back where somebody shot him with an AK. But he's so big, he just was like, yeah, whatever.
Sounds like he'd make a great carpet.
He's 20-something feet long.
I want a pair of boots made out of humans.
There would probably be enough material left over after I have my carpet.
They're thinking his kill count is over 300.
Wow.
They know around 300 for sure, but because of how rural those areas are, it's like if someone goes missing, you may never hear about it.
Now, I have a serious question, serious debate, something that's been nagging on my mind for the last few days.
Feelings are not the sin, but acting on the feelings are the sin. So,
you know, eat a bag of records. I've been hardcore thinking about playing an MMO. I just can't figure out.
There are no good MMOs. Give it up. Yeah. They don't exist. The days of Badass EQ or Dark Age of Camelot are over.
So, what's the Red Room Games just sent me an email because I'm on their mailing list, and they got this one book I really like the cover of.
Do tell.
Tears of Belfigure or whatever. I would pull it up, but it would get Hungar's stream taken down.
Oh, well, I'm going to look it up then.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to put it on Hungar's stream.
Yeah.
Aren't they the ones that did the man game?
Yes.
Yeah, I want a samurai. They're Brazilians or something, and they're always like pissing everybody off.
They need to come out with a Japanese samurai MMO.
I will put it in.
No, I was thinking of something else.
I will put it in the private chat.
Is it a woman in like a chainmail bikini?
No, that's too much clothing.
It's got the boobies.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, look at the private chat. That's a nice book cover.
Yeah. Cover.
They only want $2.50 for it.
Send me a link later there, Justin.
They got a role-playing game called Supermax.
Jesus.
Where you're just like, I guess, in a Supermax prison.
That does not sound like fun.
Hey, and you know out there with Big Geek Emporium. That's pretty cool.
Right on.
They have a Asian style game, Wretched Klimbara.
Yeah.
Demons of Chernobyl. That's cool.
Well, I got to go eat lunch, guys. Thanks for having me on there, Hungar.
Hey, take care, Jackie.
Oh, Jesus, I completely forgot to record that thing for Jackie. Ah, shiza, sorry. I'm knee-deep in heroic. It slipped my mind. I'll try and get to it there today or tomorrow.
All right.
Tell him I'm sorry.
No, no worries, dude. You know, it's it was a big weekend.
Do you want a pester email? I could like annoy you if I remember.
Yeah, you know, tell Jackie he's free to send me a message. Justin, never speak to me again. You're dead to me.
Why?
Because the guild has decided I'm not allowed to arch you.
Is that because we're both Canadian?
They're trying to go international, and that's why they're going to give it to James.
Hell yeah.
But we're both Canadian. The guild has no authority over us.
Oh, no, I pay my dues. I have to abide by the rules.
It's international.
Surprisingly, though, they've said I could arch Hungar if I wanted to. And I'm like, I don't want to arch Hungar. I want to recruit Hungar. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
This is actually a good cover that no one should be offended by. Wretched Bastard, second edition.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to pick up a couple of books from Wretched because apparently OG GM wrote them. And I'm in a game with him tomorrow night. And he's kind of a fun guy to hang out with.
Yeah, I know him. He's ex-army too. No, OJGM's not X Army. That's Unchained and Un.
Yeah,
yeah.
And I mean, he's our GM for that game. So, small world.
Okay, Belphegor, of course, is the name of one of the Dukes of Hell.
That was the one I sent the link to. Tears of.
Yeah, Belphegor is he a president, a king, or a duke? I forget.
I don't care. The cover art is great on that one book.
So, hey, Hungar, who won the contest?
Yeah.
The contest just starts this month, dude.
Oh, I thought it was over this month. Or last month. It
starts on the 10th of this month.
Oh, shit. I pushed the boy to get that done.
I'm doing a contest, Hungar Mini Contest. Get your Hungar Mini on Colt. Download it, paint it.
Oh, shit, dude.
It starts on the 10th. It goes until the end of April, and the winner will be announced in the first week of May.
Oh, really? And shit. I pushed Jackie all month to get that done. I thought it was
over. Well, it was good. It's good for him, though.
Well, yeah. he's the first runner-up right now.
Nice.
Yeah. I'll let him know. If you have early submissions, Hungar will accept them. As long as they're done within the same amount of time frame. Yeah. Because Hungar doesn't give a shit. Right, Hungar?
Yeah, Hungar really gives zero shits.
Okay, Hungar. I'm going to send you a private message.
Oh, James is disqualified. He's my arch nemesis, so.
Yeah. You can choose whether you want to put that up or not.
That's just a...
That is a very long away shot of a 20-something foot man-eating crocodile that, like I said, has at least 300 bodies. At least. That's Gustav. Mm-hmm. He's so big that he makes other crocodiles look like dwarves. Like, there's a picture top down of like a bunch of crocodiles all hanging out and Gustav's in the middle. His head is four times bigger than the heads of any of the other ones.
Hmm.
They also think he eats crocodiles, too, when he's not.
Crocodiles always eat other crocodiles.
Yeah. But basically.
Hey, man, if I thought I could get away with that, I'd eat people, too.
They go down to get water, and Gustav waits for them because somehow something almost 30 feet long can be really sneaky. And. You know, they go down and dip their gut bucket into the water and Gustav gets them.
That supplies.
And then what he does, because Gustav is smart, is after he eats somebody at a village, he journeys like 100 miles down the river. And he spends a month digesting the meal. And that's what makes him so difficult to catch, because, you know, he's been operating for like 16 years and they know it's him because he's pale and he's got a scarred up back where somebody shot him with an AK. But, and he's in that river chain that like basically stretches all the way across Central Africa and goes up into Lake Victoria or whatever and all that. So you never know where he is. If you live anywhere in Central Africa, every time you walk near water, you got to ask yourself, you know, is Gustav in there? Because if he's in there, he's going to get you. I saw an interview of a dude. Gustav got him, and he hooked his arm around a tree and just let Gustav take the arm and ran back to the village. He like held on to a tree so hard that it was like, boom, arm gone. So
Dakota just put a video out 36 minutes ago.
Who did?
Dakota. This is Castles and Crusades Session 34. His Castles and Crusade videos, if you haven't seen them or watched them, you should, because they're freaking badass.
Yeah. Castles and Crusades is a good game, but I never use the siege system. I always just roll under your attribute. Because, you know, that's basically what Gustav is. He's like 27 feet long,
but this one,
and he is a man-eating machine. And because of the way crocodiles are, if he eats a man, then he don't go eat again for another month or two. So it's real intermittent.
Excuse me.
Plus, he travels the length and breadth of that whole river, you know, like the deltas and all that. So it's like, oh, I'm going to hunt Gustav. Well, welcome to Africa. You know, he's somewhere out there. Good luck with that. Try not to get caught by any of those lion-killing chimpanzees.
Watch out for the hippos.
Yeah, if you're going to be in the water, watch out for a hippo, because that joker chooses violence every time. You're actually more likely to get killed by a hippo than Gustav.
Yeah. Hippos kill a lot of people.
Around 500 get checked off the census every year by hippos. And number two after the hippo is the black cape buffalo, which the Africans refer to as the Black Death. Because if you F around with that boy, you will find out.
Yeah. Hippos kill 500 people annually, where lions kill about 22 people.
Right.
Yeah. One's got a better marketing department, though.
Yeah.
That whole lion African safari thing.
Well, I was saying the other day, you know, all of the worst animals on the planet are herbivores. But it's just something about, they just choose violence. Like zebras are mean as shit.
Top 10 deadliest animals to humans. Hippo, number one. Number two is elephants. Number three is the saltwater croc.
Well, yeah.
Number four is roundworms.
Roundworms?
Yeah.
Yeah, they get into you and they eat you.
Number five is fog up your
digestion or something like that.
Scorpions? Well, yeah, in Saudi Arabia and Iraq, they're all over the place.
2,600 people per year.
Damn.
Wow.
10 is assassin bugs.
Never heard of them.
Or 6 is assassin bugs. That's an ugly son of a bitch.
It's called an assassin bug, so you know it ain't good.
Seven is soft-shelled viper. 8 is freshwater snails.
Yeah, because dumbasses eat them, right?
Yeah, dumbasses.
Nine is peoples.
Well, yeah.
And 10 is mosquitoes. But I've said it before and I'll say it again. If we could send more mosquito nets to Africa, we could save millions of mosquitoes from AIDS every year.
The problem is the Africans keep tearing them off.
Shadow kind of like roll that through his brain was amazing. Just the look, the emotions on his face.
I couldn't believe he said that.
It's just... the problem is Africans keep tearing them up to use them for toilet paper or whatever.
Well, the problem is we decide to get rid of DDT because we're good-natured people, and it inadvertently led to the death of millions of Africans.
Maybe it wasn't so inadvertent.
DDT was really good at getting rid of the malaria-causing mosquitoes. But once we got rid of the DDT, which might have caused cancer, sure, but then malaria ran rampant, and
oddly, the African population has done nothing but explode since then.
Well, because they don't have condoms and they need more kids to work on their farms.
Hippos are more deadly than lions because one, hippos are very, very territorial, and two, there's a lot more hippos than lions.
Like, you know what the hippo's closest relative on Earth is?
A whale.
Blue whales. They're cetaceans.
And they are, hippos wake up every morning and choose violence.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hippos will bite a crocodile in half just for fun.
Like a rhino's the same way. But usually when a rhino runs someone down and kills them, it's kind of an accident because the rhino can't really see very well. So it just sees movement and assumes lion.
And elephants killing people 90% of the time is an accident, except for that one elephant who killed that Indian woman and then came to her funeral and destroyed everything at the funeral. That shit was personal.
That was a personal situation.
They say they never forget. I wonder what the hell she did.
Yeah, there was a dude in Africa that saved a baby hippo, raised it, and then it killed him because it's a hippo. I mean, I didn't know what you thought it was going to do.
They may be cute when they're little, but they are called hungry hippos for a reason.
That's why I keep saying we need our government to engineer the house hippo. Remember the house hippo I showed you guys the?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, we tried that. We got Lizzo.
Lizzo's good in music.
She needs to.
She was in music?
But that's because she realized it wasn't magic. Oh, wait, no, that was a different...
she needs to work on not dying of diabetes or something. It's kind of hard to perform on stage for missing a leg.
I thought she was already halfway there.
I'm just saying, you know, if they start hacking feet off and shit, it's kind of hard to be a performer. Anyway, that's
here it. We go.
You're being
sinister. I am, and that's okay though.
The internet after fat shaming Lizzo into quitting, everybody's happy.
Yay!
We all got what we want. Well, except her.
Well, I mean, they let her play the crystal flute that no one had touched in 200 years.
That's not right.
No. But anyway, yeah, that was from National Geographic. That's old Gustav just kind of laying there, you know, thinking about his next mass murder because...
What else has he got to do?
300 people on the banks of the Ruzizi River, northern shores of Lake Tanganyika. He roams the whole distance, so that makes him really hard to catch.
Well, I'm getting ready to end the show, and I'm going to end it with a video.
They caught him one time in a...
Hold on. Before you end the show, Hungar. I got a big guest coming on Thursday. Instead of it being a paid stream, it's going to be another Arduin stream. So I hope you guys will come and check it out. We've got a major announcement coming that I'm overjoyed to be a part of. So please check out the show Thursday night at 5 p.m. avocado time.
Awesome. Check this
video out. 9:30.
Is it the Star Wars one?
Wake us up, Black. Yes.
Now and then I think of when I was in power. Like joking people with the Force until they died. But then you told them all my history and took away my masculinity. And had my character portrayed by subpar actors. Addicted to an overuse of graphics and making Greedo shoot first on shot first. So when you try to have the Force make sense, you introduce the midichlorians. And what's the deal with having me be dubbed over? But you didn't have to change it all. Make them like they never happened and the fans are nothing. I don't even need your love. You treat me like a panther and I feel so rough. No, you didn't have to make them blow. Have your friends direct your movies and they'll turn out better. You think that you don't need. Of all the times I screwed fans over, I had them believing that the first three films were really done. But Star Wars will be done my way. I don't care what they have to say. I think that they should let it go, and they'll never get a Blu-ray of the Star Wars that you used to know. You didn't have to change it all. No more puppets, no more practical effects or nothing. I don't even need your love. You treat me like a whopper and I feel so cold. No, you didn't have to sell your soul. Do we really need to watch them all again in 3D? Jar Jar was an all-time low. What happened to the Star Wars that I used to know? Movies.
Jar Jar was an all-time low.
Yeah, at the very end of that video, what you miss is like all the paint turns into a green screen.
Yeah.
And it's a subtle way of, you know, basically stabbing at the fact that they use too much.
They use too much. But guys, thanks for coming on the show today. It was fun. I had a blast.
Always a pleasure.
I'm going to go get something to eat.
Yeah.
Your boy's hungry.
Yeah. I know what I'm getting.
You're getting Greek food.
Yeah. Which is, you know what? Most Greek food is keto friendly, so.
Yeah, where do you find all this stuff, Hungar?
I found that years ago, and James just reposted it recently.
Yeah, that video? Or yeah. If you're talking about Greek food, I live in Orlando. I can get any kind of food.
I meant the video. Same as...
like, if I wanted to get Congolese food that was, like, you know, full of cobalt, I could do it.
Full of cobalt.
Can I show one more thing? This is just freaking awesome.
Shadow, it's called YouTube.
Okay, well, I never see stuff like that.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Immobile Suit Gundam.
Immobile Suit Gundam.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good. a mobile suit Gundam. Yeah, he's just kind of sitting there.
What was that? The original song for that?
Someone You Used to Know by Guillotine.
Gotye.
It's actually a pretty good song.
It is a good song, and his song Bronte is amazing. And
it reminds me of old school.
Your Heart Mess is amazing.
It reminds me of old school Peter Gabriel.
Basically, everything that Gotye did was pretty amazing. But he is a Belgian man, but he lives in New Zealand.
New Zealand?
Yeah, well, apparently there's a lot of Russians in New Zealand and Australia as well.
Well, yeah. Peace up, chicken grease, everybody.
Hey, Eagle Rider just showed up in time to be all like, I like his, okay, Eagle Rider, happy.
Hey, long time no see.
Yeah.
Happy heterodox Easter to all of you. I hope you're going to spend time with your families and have a good time. And which means probably no Greek food because all the Greek restaurants, well, they'll be open because Greek Easter isn't for a couple weeks.
Why do you think I always eat Chinese or Asian food on holidays?
Right. So
because it's a tradition?
Yeah, because they're always open.
Jewish.
No, because it's from the Christmas story when they the hounds ate the turkey, so they had to go out and order a duck.
Yep.
And the Chinese guys are trying to sing Christmas songs, and they're like, rah, 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 rah.
All right, guys. Have a great day.
Yeah. We could go long. I don't have work today, so.